So when you have your scene set up or your UI set up, what you're going to do is you're going to import all of your images. Like say these are all just like still images. If I turn this off, there's nothing there. This is like one, two, three. These are the three options that we're going to use. So I want to be able to click on these buttons and select one of the options. So I'm going to start off by, I'm just going to turn off these two layers for now. And with this selected, so the button that I'm going to use to choose that is the option three, which is the wolf button, right? So if I go to the wolf button with that selected, when we come here in our inspector, we have certain options here. And this tells us what's going to happen when we click on this. So on click, what is going to happen? So if I click add here and it says none object, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to drag and drop the wolf in here, and I'm going to go here and I'm going to go to game object, and I'm going to set active and use the bool. So when I check this, what it's going to do is it's going to make sure that this is on. I also want to make sure that these two turn off when I select that. So I go here, I drag toothless in here, go here, go to game object, and then uncheck that. That way it will turn off toothless and the cat. So go to game object, set bool, and that's unchecked. I also want to be able to, so if this is like, I'm just going to change this to select wolf. Or select toothless is fine too. So now I've already set that up for toothless and for the dragon button, as you can see here, that it turns on the toothless sprite and turns off the other two. And similarly over here. So the other thing that I want to do in my dragon button is, I want to add my select toothless button here. Do the same game object. And then I want to make sure that that turns on. I would similarly make duplicates of these buttons. I would call this select cat. And then make another duplicate of this and call it select. So what I want is with my dragon button, I want to make sure that select cat and select wolf are off. So I'm going to add another and repeat that, make sure that turns off, and add another game object, select wolf, game object. And all right, so now what should happen is like if I hit play and with option, toothless should appear and select option for select toothless should appear. Select toothless. I'm going to uncheck these so these are not showing on top of that. So select toothless. I go here, cat button, and I make sure that select cat is checked on, and select toothless gets turned off. So similarly, you'll do that for the dog, and I'm just going to make sure just so that you guys can see better. Not the button here, but the select cat. Did I do that? Did I do that? Just gonna double check. Select toothless and select cat. Yeah, so select cat here in the text here. I'm just gonna make sure select cat there. So it's gonna show us the difference. Now, if I hit play, you can see if I click on this, it says select toothless here. Now it says select cat, select toothless, select cat. The next thing that we're going to do is we're going to make this button clickable. So in order to do that, we are going to create a new script, and you can do that by right-clicking here and create new C# script, and we're going to call this select toothless button. And you see that it creates something like a starting script for us. If you double click on it, it'll open this in either MonoDev or Visual Studio. I'm going to delete these. Void starts. Start is the function that is called before the first frame updates, so before the game starts, this is called. So it does the settings here. And update is called per frame, so it loops. We're just going to delete that. And we want to make sure here, when we're telling our code here, that we're using a package called the Unity Engine Scene Management is what we're using. Okay. And then what we're going to do is we are going to we are going to public void, say on start, I believe, start, and hold up, let me just double check what that is, on start game. So on start game, which is a function that we're going to call. And then we are going to say, we are going to use the bracket keys because we already have that. And now we're going to tell the scene manager to load our scene called, I believe I saved the name as scene 3, and then we're going to save this, and I'm going to minimize this. And then here, if I go here, you see how it says that here. Hopefully this will work. So we're going to create, so the first thing that you want to do is, I'm going to delete this for now. So what we're going to do is create an empty object, call it select toothless button, so that I don't get confused, or object actually, this is an object. Object, and then go here in our select toothless button. So there isn't too much confusion. What we're going to do is, see how it says on click do something? We wanted to run this script. So we have this object, we're going to add our script to it. Click, drag, and drop on it. It's added it. You can add it by clicking on add component and choosing the script, you know. So now going back to our drag and button, we are going to, wait, it was select toothless button. We are going to drag and drop this game object that has our script on it, and then go to select toothless button on start game. So next thing, we want to make sure that our scenes have been added to our build. You can add them, see it's called scene 3 is right here, it's added. If you want to know how to add it, what you can do is, I'm going to save this scene, file, save, and go to our scenes, open scene 3, click add open. Now if I go back to my level, should have called it character select screen, but now if I go here and hit play, and select option one. This should take me to your you selected toothless. So that's it. That's how you are going to code your stuff, your buttons, from switching from one scene to another. All right.